Okay, now let us learn the equation for whitewashing. What is the compound that is used for whitewashing? The compound used for whitewashing is calcium oxide. Calcium oxide is otherwise known as quicklime. When calcium oxide combines with water, we get calcium hydroxide. This is also known as slaked lime. When calcium hydroxide combines with carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, we get calcium carbonate, CaCO3 and H2O. This CaCO3 form is white in color. This is the compound that gives white color in the whitewashing. Now the important thing is, this equation is also used for the test for carbon dioxide. For example, if you are getting a question, how will you test the presence of carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide turns lime water milky. Okay, just listen here. This is lime water or calcium hydroxide basically. When carbon dioxide is passed through it, you will get white calcium carbonate. That gives milkiness. So this is also used for the test for carbon dioxide. Now let us see what happens when ferrous sulfate and lead nitrate crystals are heated. When you heat these two, both will undergo thermal decomposition reaction. When green color ferrous sulfate crystals are heated, you will get brown Fe2O3 with the smell of burning sulfur. Why the smell of burning sulfur? Because you are getting two important products, SO2 and SO3 here. Both are gases. Here, let us see the questions that could be asked for board exams. A green color crystal X, when heated, changes to brown colored compound Y. Okay, so this is X and this is Y. Along with the smell of burning sulfur, identify X and Y and write the chemical equation. This could be asked for a 3-mark question or a 2-mark question. Okay, and the answer would be like this. The green color substance or the green color crystal is ferrous sulfate. The formula is FeSO4. When you heat this, it undergoes thermal decomposition reaction to form brown color Fe2O3, that is ferric oxide, that is Y. Along with the smell of burning sulfur is due to the production of sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. You may also get a question, what type of reaction is this? I already mentioned this is thermal decomposition reaction. Let us come to the next example. By heating lead nitrate crystals, you get lead oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. This is also a thermal decomposition reaction. When you heat lead nitrate crystals, you get brown color nitrogen dioxide gas. Here also the question comes like this. What happens when lead nitrate crystals get heated? What are the important observations? So you can write the brown color NO2 will evolve in this particular reaction. This also comes under thermal decomposition reaction.